All right, everybody, the day has come. I have a selfie stick. So I'm here at camp now, just making supper, or hot water as it were, over my shoulder. And why don't you come join me?
So we've got a little Chinese $6 stove, and that's our fuel.
Nice little splatter screen here. And just boiling up some water. You see it's just coming up to the boiler. And today we're gonna have AlpineAire's spicy sausage pasta. And I've already removed this. Don't eat that. And I look inside and I see some lovely little spinny bits of pasta and chunks of what look like sausage and such. So you add 1¾ cups of water. I like these packages because it says to add to the number 7. Hopefully the focus can pick up on this. There's numbers on the side of the package. So you fill it up once you've ballooned the packaging out to whatever number they tell you on the back. It says here, package number, easy fill line number 7. So that makes it easy. You don't have to measure any water, which is one of the things I find difficult in the field because my pots don't have measuring points on them. So the water is well boiled. I'm going to turn that off. And we're going to add some water. All right, so the water's thoroughly boiled. Got the package open again and hinted out, I believe, as they say, on the packaging. Now this is, what do we got here? 600 calories per package. Just add water, 24 grams of protein per package. It does contain pork. Got a warning here. If you're not into pork, then you don't want to do this. And the other nutritional information, I'll bring it up for you here. Hopefully that's on screen and we can read it. If not, I'll take a still of it later. So we're looking at about, for this whole container, and it says it's 2 servings. Per serving is 300 calories, 11 grams of fat, 25 mg of cholesterol, 440 of sodium, 40 grams of carbs, 3 grams of fiber, 5 grams of sugar, and 12 grams of protein. 110% of your vitamin C, 15% of calcium and iron. So that's for half of the package, so I'm going to be eating most of it. So it should be good. Packaging wise, this is dated for 04-2020. So this is still good for a few years anyways. So I'm going to take my hot water out of my little pot here and try and pour it into their line, which is about number 7. So the 7 is here. I'll do my best to pour that without splashing everywhere. And that 7. Well, it might be a little bit too much, but it's pretty darn close. I'm going to give that a good stir. I'm going to use my long-handled fork on that one. This is the titanium Vargo. Very handy if you're eating directly out of these packages, by the way. Which I might do. I'm not sure yet. I also have another fork I wanted to show you. This one is I'll show you in a second when it gets this stirred up and sealed up. So, well stirred to the corners. Right now it's quite soupy, but we'll give it a few minutes to do its thing. It says 11 to 13. So I'm going to close most of it up, push out most of the air, put it into my famous Optimus thing here. Sorry for the traffic noise. And we'll leave it in there for the next, I think it said 11 minutes or so. So I'll get you back. So
while
there.
We're waiting for this to do its thing and rehydrate, just wanted to show you another spork. I know I showed Oregon Bushcraft spork not long ago, which is a good tool. This is another one I got off of the eBay or the Amazon, which I really like. It's called a Soto, S-O-T-O. It's made in Japan. It's titanium here, and this is stainless. So it's got the little dewy, so you can tighten that up. Folds up, quite small, compact. It's quite light. Clicks in. Fold that, slide that down, then it doesn't go anywhere. If you can see how it's slightly off kilter, this is quite ergonomic, so it's easy to use, easy to grab in a bunch of different positions. It's got a great bowl for the spoon, and it's got a little bit of teethies for that. So I think if you're trying to try and do a steak on this, you're going to have a hard time. But if you're doing soup or noodles or pasta with sauces and such, this is probably one of the better sporks that I've got so far for that, and I've got a lot of sporks. If you watch my videos regularly, you'll see that on my channel. So we're almost up to time here for this, so give me a minute, I'll bring
you back.
So now we're here for the moment of truth. It's been about 15 minutes. Open this up. I've stirred it twice since I put the water in. And I think I put a little too much water in. But that's okay. The little tastes that I had. I'm having a little trouble. I got my thumbnail, so I can't get this open. There we go. Bring you in for a quick one here. Hold tight. So that's what she looks like. A little bit watery, so might go a little bit less water next time. Just that. And we'll give it a taste. So it's got lots of noodles. It's got red and green peppers. Little chunks of sausage. I'll bring you in for a close one here. Taste-wise, it's got a bit of an Alfredo type of taste, with a bit of kick to it. I'll try a good big bite here. Excuse me if I chomp too loud. Good and hot. Yeah, completely palatable. It's a little bit of spice to it, and good texture. The noodles are nice and soft. They've rehydrated well. As I said, there's a little too much water in here, but I can eat around that, and it won't be an issue. The vegetable parts, looks like carrot or red pepper, and some green pepper, or a chive or a green onion of sorts. They seem to have rehydrated well also, and you can pick out the distinct flavors and the distinct textures, which is always nice. One more bite. Yeah, that's overall, that's a winner. I would rebuy this and put it back in my pack any day. I'm going to tuck into this. We were doing the AlpineAire spicy sausage pasta with pork, and this is a double serving, so I'm going to eat most of it best as I can. Then I'm going to tuck in, keep my fire going, relax for the evening, and hit the rack. So thank you for watching. We'll see you on the next one.